Hi, good evening students. This is Madhav again. Today we are going to discuss about eye defects. So all these eye defects occur due to the focal length adjustments. In our earlier class we have already discussed about accommodation. What is meant by accommodation? The ability of the eye lens to change the focal length when we see the objects at far distances or when we see the objects near distances is known as accommodation. So this the focal length of eye lens adjusted by the help of ciliary muscles. That's why we can say that the maximum focal length of the eye lens when we see the objects at far distances is 2.5 centimeters, and the minimum focal length of the eye lens when we see the objects which are placed at least distance of distinct vision is 2.27 centimeters. Beyond this, if the eye lens of any human being beyond these limitations, at the time he get some blurred when he see the objects either nearer or far objects. That's why in this class we are going to discuss about the eye defects. All those eye defects occurred due to the adjustment of the focal length when lacked, or the lack of adjustment of the focal length of the eye lens. So these eye defects are three types. One is myopia, and second one is hypermetropia, and third one is presbyopia. First, myopia. It is also called as near sightedness. So what is meant by myopia? Which type of lens are used to correct the myopia if any person who suffers from this eye defect? First of all, myopia. Any person who suffers from myopia, who can see the near objects very clearly, but he cannot see the objects which are placed at infinite distances or far distances, because the maximum focal length of his eye lens is less than 2.5 centimeters. When the light rays comes from those objects which are placed at far distances, those light rays incident on the eye lens and gets a refraction, and all those light rays meets before the retina so that the image is not formed on the retina. So once again, myopia. Any person who suffers from myopia, who can see the near objects very clearly but who can't see the far objects, because the maximum focal length of the eye lens of those person who suffers from myopia is less than 2.5 centimeters. So that the light rays which comes from the objects which are placed at infinite distances or far distances incident on the lens of the eye and gets refraction, all those refracted rays coincide before the retina so that the clear image is not formed on the retina. So any healthy human being who can see the objects which are placed at least distance of distinct vision, also the objects which are placed at infinite distances, but the person who suffers from myopia, who can see the objects very clearly, those are placed at least distance of distinct vision, and also those person can see the objects which are placed beyond the least distance of distinct vision up to certain distance. If we assume one point at this distance, at that distance where you can see very clearly, those point is called as far point. Those point is called as far point, which is denoted by the letter M. So what is meant by far point? The point of maximum distance at which the eye lens can form the images on the retina, those point is called far point. Once again, the point of maximum distance, if we place any objects at this point or the dam, the islands formed images of those objects on the retina. Those point is called far point. Here we are discussing myopia. So any person or any human being who suffers from myopia, who can see the objects very clearly, those objects which are placed at least distance of distinct vision, and also he can see, any person who suffers from myopia, he can see the objects which are placed at far point, and also if the objects placed between L and M, this place, whatever it may, wherever it may be, all those places, if the objects are placed at L, either L or M or between L and M, the images of those objects must be formed on the retina. If any objects which are placed beyond M, at the time, he can't see those objects because the images of those objects formed before the retina. Here, if you observe this diagram, here one object is placed at infinite distance. Infinite distance means the light rays which comes from that object moves parallel to the principal axis of the islands, so that those light rays coincide and meet at one point. This point is before the retina, so that in this case, this person can't see the images of those objects which are placed at infinite distance properly. In the second case, here also one object is placed beyond the far point. In this case also, the refracted rays meet before the retina, so that in this case also, this person can't see the proper image of this object very clearly, because here also this after refraction on the islands, those refracted rays coincide before the retina. That's why we can say that any person who suffers from myopia, who cannot see the objects which are placed at infinite distances or far distances, in other words, any person who suffers from myopia, he cannot see the objects which are placed at infinite distances or beyond far point. He can see only the objects which are placed either at L or at M or between L and M. That's why we define one point. Those point is called far point, the point of maximum distance at which the islands formed images on the retina. So to correct this eye defect, what we have to do? So we have used one biconcave lens to correct the myopia eye defect. We have to use one biconcave lens. So here observe the diagram. So this is the lens, this is eyeball, so before the eye we have to use one biconcave lens. For example, this is called the least distance of distinct vision, this is called far point, if the light rays, in this case here we are placed one object at infinite distance or far distances. So again you recall the ray diagrams of biconcave lens. If you put any object in front of biconcave lens, what happened? One light ray which passes from the bottom of the object through the principal axis, the corresponding refracted ray doesn't deviate its direction, and also one light ray which passes from the top portion of the object and incident at any one point. So in the case of biconcave, F1 C1 F2 C2. So the corresponding refracted ray seems to be passes through the focus point. If you extend in the backward direction, it passes through the first focus point. One more light ray which comes from top portion of the object and passes through the optic center, the corresponding refracted ray doesn't deviate its direction. If you extend these two refracted rays in the backward direction, those light rays intersect at one point. From that point of intersection, you draw one normal to the principal axis, we get the index. Same here also, these light rays passes refracted in this direction. This light ray refracted in this direction. If you extend these refracted rays in the backward direction, those refracted rays meet at far point M. So here we are placed one object at infinite distance, and also we placed one biconcave lens in front of the eye. The image of those object is formed at far point. This image is acting as a object to the eye lens, so that the image is formed on the retina. So to correct the myopia eye defect, we should use one biconcave lens. So to correct the myopia, we should use one biconcave lens. What is the focal length of those biconcave lens? So to find the focal length of the eye lens when the myopia occurred, so according to lens formula, 1 by F is equals to 1 by V minus 1 by U. Here, U, where the object is placed at infinite distance, so that the object distance is infinite. While measuring the distance, this is the incident light direction. We are moving opposite to incident light direction, so that U becomes negative. Next, where the image is formed at far point M. The distance between eye lens and far point M is denoted by the letter D, so that the distance of the image is D. Here also, while measuring the distance of the image, we are moving opposite to incident light direction, so that it becomes also negative. Substitute these two values in the above equation, we get 1 by F is equals to 1 by minus V minus 1 by minus infinity. So 1 by F is equals to 1 by minus D, minus of minus plus 1 by infinity. 1 by F is equals to 1 by minus D, 1 by infinity means 0. So F is equals to minus D. So here, minus indicates the focal length of the biconcave lens, which is used to correct the eye defect myopia. So the focal length of the, in our earlier classes, we have already discussed about the focal length of biconcave lens always must be negative, so that F is equals to minus D. So to correct the myopia eye defect, we should use one biconcave lens. The focal length of those biconcave lens must be minus D. F is equals to minus D. So this is the myopia eye defect. So once again, myopia means Any person who suffers from myopia, who can see the near objects very clearly, but who can't see the objects which are placed at infinite distances or far distances, because the maximum focal length of his eye lens is less than 2.5 centimeters. Hi students, good afternoon. Today we are going to discuss about hypermetropia. It is also called as farsightedness. What is meant by hypermetropia? Any person who suffers from hypermetropia, who can see the far objects very clearly, but he can't see the near objects because the minimum focal length of his eye lens is greater than 2.27 centimeters. So that the light rays which comes from the objects which are placed at near distances or least distance of distinctive vision, those light rays gets a refraction on the eye lens. After the refraction, all those refracted rays meet behind the retina. A person with hypermetropia can see the near objects up to certain distance. If we imagine any one point or the distance, those point is called near point, which is denoted by the letter H. Any person with myopia who can see the objects which are placed at a near point or beyond the near point, but any person with myopia who can't see the objects which are placed at least distance of the distinctive vision, or the objects which are placed between least distance of distinctive vision and near point. A person with myopia who can see the objects which are placed at near point or beyond the near point. So, once again, hypermetropia. Any person who suffers from hypermetropia, who can see the far objects very clearly, but who can't see the near objects or objects which are placed at least distance of distinctive vision, because the minimum focal length of his eye lens is greater than 2.27 centimeters. A person with myopia can see the near objects up to certain distance. If we imagine or assume one point at the distance, those point is called a near point. So near point can be defined as, the point of minimum distance at which the eye lens formed images on the retina. Those point is called near point. So near point is denoted by the letter H. Any person, if you see all three diagrams, any person who suffers from myopia can see the objects which are placed at the edge or beyond edge, but he can't see the objects which are placed at L or between L and H. To correct this hypermetropia defect, we should use one biconvex lens. So this is the lens. This is the eyeball. Least distance of distinct vision and edge. To correct this hypermetropic defect, we should use one biconvex lens. So if we place one biconvex lens in front of the person with myopia and place one object at least distance of distinctive vision, the light rays which emits from this object and incident are the incident on the lateral surface of this biconvex lens. So recall the ray diagrams.
in the case of biconvex excellence. So this is F2, this is C2, this is F1, this is C1. Any object which is placed between focus point and optic center, the light ray from this object passes through the principal axis, the corresponding refractive ray doesn't deviate its direction. One more light ray which passes from the upper portion of the object and travels parallel to the principal axis, the corresponding refracted ray passes through the focus point. Take one more light ray which comes from the upper portion of the object and passes through the optic center, the corresponding refracted ray doesn't deviate its direction. If you extend these two refracted rays in the backward direction, those two light rays must intersect at any one point. From that point of intersection, you draw one normal to the principal axis, you get the image. This is the image. Here also, here you put one object at least distance of distinct vision. The light rays which passes from this object incident at this place are the biconvex lens. The image of this object formed, the image of this object formed at H, formed at H. This image acts as a object to the eye lens so that the light rays from this image intersect on the retina. In this manner, the image, clear image formed on the retina. The person with myopia perceive the clear image on his retina if he use one biconvex lens. So, what is meant by hypermetropia? Hypermetropia, any person who suffers from hypermetropia, he can see the far objects very clearly, but he can't see the near objects because the minimum focal length of his eye lens is greater than 2.27 centimeters. So that the light rays which comes from those objects which are placed at near distances, refracted on the eye lens, after refraction those refracted rays intersect at one point behind the retina. So to correct this side effect, we should use one biconvex lens. Now we are going to discuss about the focal length of the biconvex lens, which is used to correct the hypermetropia defect. Hypermetropia defect. Here the distance between near point and the lens is denoted by the letter small d. Small d. So by using lens formula, 1 by f is equals to 1 by v minus 1 by u. So here u is equals to 25 centimeters, where we place the object at least distance of distinct vision. For any healthy human being, the least distance of distinct vision is 25 centimeters. So u is equals to 25 centimeters. V, where the image is formed at H. So H is equals to the distance between the optic center of the lens and near point is D. So while measuring these distances, we are moving opposite to incident light directions so that we take negative sign for these both values. So substitute these values in this equation and we get 1 by f is equals to 1 by minus d, 1 by minus of minus 25. It can be written as 1 by f is equals to 1 by minus d plus 1 by 25. 1 by f is equals to 1 by 25 minus 1 by d. So 1 by f is equals to 25d, LCM 25d, we get d minus 25. So f is equals to 25d by d minus 25. If you substitute all these variables in this value, we get f must be positive. The focal length of the lens which is used to correct the hypermetropia defect must be positive means to correct the hypermetropia defect we should use one biconvex lens. The focal length of those lens is f is equals to 25 d by d minus 25. Okay, so now we are going to discuss third eye defect, presbyopia. So due to the decreasing in the accommodation, due to the decreasing in the flexibilities of ciliary muscles, and also due to the less strength in the nerves which are located around our eye, and due to age and due to health conditions, some persons who neither see the near objects nor see the far objects, those type of eye defect is called presbyopia. So presbyopia means any person who suffers from presbyopia, who can't see the near objects as well as who can't see the far objects, because the ability of the accommodation is in his eye lens gradually decreases, and also the flexibility of the ciliary muscles also decreases, and also the nerves which are located around those persons' eye is also decreases, and also health conditions and yes, that's why the person with presbyopia neither see the near objects nor see the far objects. So any person who suffers from presbyopia, who must use one bifocal lens, the lens which is used to correct the myopia, in which the upper portion of those lens consists biconcave and lower portion of the his lens consists biconvex. For example, these are the spectacles which are used to correct the presbyopia defect of any person. So the lens which is used to correct the presbyopia, in which the upper portion of the lens consists of biconcave. The lower portion of the lens consists of biconvex. So this is the presbyopia eye defect. So due to the ability of the accommodation of the eye lens decreases, less flexibility in the ciliary muscles and less strength in the nerves which are located around the eye, and due to all these causes, some persons who neither see the near objects nor see the far objects very clearly, those type of eye defect is called presbyopia. So now we are going to discuss power of lens. So we have already discussed about the eye defects such as myopia, hypermetropia and presbyopia. To correct all those eye defects, we should use either biconcave lens or biconvex lens or bifocal lens. So what is the power of those lens? First of all, what is meant by power? The degree of converging or diverging of the light rays which are achieved by those lens is called power of those lens. Once again, the degree of converging or diverging of the light rays which are achieved by those lens is called the power of those lens. So in other words, the reciprocation of the focal length of the eye lens is also called as power of the eye lens. For example, it can be algebraically expressed as P is equals to 1 by f meters, 1 by f meters, where f is the focal length of those lens which is used in this context. So P is equals to 100 by, it can be written as also 100 by f centimeters, 100 by f centimeters. The units of the power of the lens is diopter. Diopter. So this is the power of the lens. The degree of converging or diverging of the light rays which are achieved by those lens is called the power of the lens. It can be algebraically expressed as P is equals to 1 by f meters or P is equals to 100 by f centimeter. The units of the power of the lens is diopter. So generally, if we observe the prescription of the any ophthalmologist, at the time we get these power values. For example, here we have some two problems. One is doctor advised to use 2D lens. What is its focal length? Here power is given. Power is equals to how much? 2 diopter. Then we have to find focal length. What is how much focal length? So P is equals to 100 by f centimeters. P is equals to 100 by f centimeters. In meters, P is equals to 1 by f meters. According to the problem, power is given. P is equals to 2 divided by 100 by f. By leading cross multiplication, f is equals to 100 by 2, that is equals to 50 centimeters. 50 centimeters. The focal length of the lens which is used when those power is 2 diopter. In the second problem, the power of the lens is 1D. Then what is the focal length of those lens? Same. P is equals to 100 by f centimeters. Here P is given how much? 1. 1 is equals to 100 by f. Then by getting cross multiplication, f is equals to 100 centimeters. Okay, so the degree of converging or diverging of the light rays which are achieved by those lens is called power of lens. So power of lens algebraically can express it as P is equals to 1 by f meters or P is equals to 100 by f centimeters. The units of the power of the lens is diopter. Okay.